Ghost Finders is brought to you by California Psychics, the best psychic reading you ever had, or it's free, www.californiapsychics.com. And by The Magic Cauldron, trinkets and charms, incense, candles, jewelry, talismans, runes, blended oils and more, www.magiccauldron.com.
I'm very conflicted and, yeah, skeptical.
Talking to a psychic over the phone is a bit impersonal.
They can't be for real, can they?
We let these skeptics try California Psychics, and here's what they had to say.
You know, it was probably the best psychic reading I've ever had.
Gosh, I got everything I can imagine from my reading.
She's telling me all this stuff, and I'm like, how can you possibly know that?
Call now to speak to a psychic for $1 per minute, and if it's not the best psychic reading you've ever experienced, it's free.
I wasn't sure about the relationship that I'm in, but now I know he's the right one.
It was specific to me. I mean, she picked up on so many things that there's no way she could have picked up on.
I've always had a passion for fitness, and she saw me owning my own yoga studio.
Speak to a psychic for $1 per minute. Readings are secure and confidential. If it's not the best psychic reading you've ever experienced, it's free.
She had names. She had so much detail.
She really just reassured me that I'm on the right path.
I've never had a phone call make me so excited for the future.
California Psychics, the best or it's free. Call today.
We are in Scotts Township, Pennsylvania, here at the Blakely Insane Asylum.
You can feel the energy change as you cross this threshold, and already there's energy even on the grounds as we speak. It's not even in the permeating just in the building, it's out here as well already.
And on top of that, we're already getting EVP and hearing voices without any electronic aid. So I think it's gonna be a busy night. We're actually gonna sandbag her in with about 250 pounds of sandbags right up against this door. There's absolutely no way that she would be able to get out.
Tell me your name.
I want out of here.
We're coming.
I'm Rob Thompson, and tonight we are in Scotts Township, Pennsylvania, at the Blakely Insane Asylum, where we'll be investigating a multitude of reports of alleged paranormal activity and seeing if we can shine a light and some truth and find out if the residents are still here. Built in 1891, the building originally known as the Blakely Poor Farm was constructed to help the less fortunate people of the Blakely Poor District. Then, in the early 1900s, it was added onto and became known as the New Insane Building in an effort for Lackawanna County to care for its own mentally insane residents.
Oh, great wizard, we summon you forth from beyond.
What wisdom do you desire?
I need a sword!
Magical potions!
Oils and steins!
Fairy wand!
Then you must journey to the Magic Cauldron.
At Magic Cauldron, you can find all the things you need. We have a unique selection of jewelry, candles, books, wands, oracle cards, and so much more.
Well, what do you think, Amber?
This is intense. Pulling up over the hill to this place, and already there's energy even on the grounds as we speak. It's not even in the permeating just in the building, it's out here as well already.
We are Blakely Insane Asylum.
Oh my goodness. Well, first of all, what I find really interesting is when I walk in this building, that the levels of the old, and then all of a sudden I see modern. So it's going to be a major cross. There's definitely a lot of residual going on here. I want to go this way. As I'm walking down this hallway, I'm being transported back to 1887. I'm seeing 1902, 1887. I'm seeing a time period in between there. Oh, even standing right here, I'm hearing screams, and I'm feeling already that they don't want me up here. I hear moaning, I hear wailing. And I get it, as I go further and further up the stairs, I get this feeling of, I'm not supposed to be here. Ooh, wow. Okay.
Voice.
I just heard a voice. I heard a girl's voice. Did you hear it off in that section?
Yeah,
I just heard that. Hi! Did you just hear it answer back to me?
No, I didn't hear that.
On night vision right now, still during the walkthrough, just now, a completely full battery that should have been good on our video light for many, many hours, fresh battery, went right out. Inexplicably, on its own. We reset it, switched it back on, went right out again. And on top of that, we're already getting EVP and hearing voices without any electronic aid. So I think it's gonna be a busy night. What do you think, Amber?
Absolutely.
All right, let's continue in night vision then after the walk around.
Sure.
We just heard two footsteps back on the steps right before we started going down. Do you feel that person's watching us right now, or here, or?
As I'm right here, this is where I'm feeling the door open and close. I'm seeing doors opening and closing by themselves. I feel that this down here has a lot of residual, but I am feeling watched, and it's coming from all the way down there. It felt like when we got to the staircase that all of a sudden, as we go down the staircase, the energy ran in here and ran back this way. But she's afraid of me, and I just heard something else.
Did you just hear that?
Yeah. There she is. I need to go down. I need to go down to the bottom ground. I feel like I need to be put in I need to be put in solitary. I need to be put in a hole. And it was because I tried to escape. I tried to... Dude, yes, I just did.
Oh, great wizard, we summon you forth from beyond.
What wisdom do you desire?
I need a sword!
Magical potions!
Oils and stains!
Fairy wand!
Then you must journey to the Magic Cauldron.
At Magic Cauldron, you can find all the things you need. We have a unique selection of jewelry, candles, books, wands, oracle cards, and so much more.
No. Okay, at this point, I need to go down. I need to go down to the bottom ground. I feel like I need to be put in solitary. I need to be put in a hole, and I want to go down all the way to the bottom, where I want to feel. I want to be in that space. I want to be in that confinement. Okay.
That makes one of us.
As I get closer and closer in here, you can feel the oppression, the heaviness. I feel back in this section, this was like a hallway that they escorted people in and out. And back in this direction, back in here, like these windows were the last daylight. These portions here were the last daylight that a patient would be screaming and running and being strapped to would see. I feel that as we get further back in here is where complete confinement is. I get
nice.
A feeling in here of being huddled in a corner, shaking and quivering, and being in filth and squalor, and begging and pleading for food. The temperature would get to people, that it would just be so utterly freezing cold that, especially in a winter time, that there was no, I feel no heat, I feel dirty. There was no water. I feel I can hear the drips of water. I felt like if there was rain, somehow there would be drips of water from the ceiling, but that there wasn't even water to drink. I also feel that people just, they died in these cells. There was no, they were forgotten. They were forgotten for a month at a time, and I feel the absolute worst of the worst of insane were in this part, criminally. And I want to say that there's a Samuel, a Samuel that was important in one of these cells. Either he figured out a way to dig through a hole or make a hole or try to find some escape route through chiseling or being able to break through a door somehow. But I do feel that he died on this property in this solitude. Not necessarily in this room, but in this location. In the attic at the Blakely Insane Asylum. Hello? Is there anyone here with us tonight? We brought a device with us. I'm gonna turn on. You're gonna see a little red light. We invite anyone who's here with us to come out of your rooms of hiding and come speak to us. This is my friend, Rob.
Hi.
And this is my other friend, Heather.
Hello.
We're not here to harm you. We come in peace and respect. We want to know what it was like to be in this location with you.
If you can hear my voice, then you will also hear the knocking noise that I am about to make. Can you finish the song rhythm of this
There was a response.
These surroundings, this place that you remain, is it as it was for you still? Did you see a light when you passed? A bright light?
When I was up here earlier, I felt like you fell out of a window, or you took your own life by jumping out of a window. Did you do that? Did you use drugs instead? Or were you given drugs? Right. If you find that you want to come speak with us, come find us in another part of the building. Okay, right now we are on the second floor with Rob and Amber. Hello.
Hi.
My name is Heather. In my hand I have a device that if you come close to it, it'll light up. All you have to do is come up to it and put your hand around the rod like so. Okay. It didn't hurt me, but won't hurt you. Are there children in here with us? Why don't you come up this way? Come towards us. We won't hurt you. Were you a child that lived on this premises with one of your families?
I heard a male voice. Can you speak louder? Can you speak louder? Oh my God. Can you knock on something like this?
I did, I moved it up there.
Well, guys, I don't know. Let's see what happens.
So far. We're going to be locking Amber in the hold underneath the stairwell. After you, dear.
Thanks. Here we go.
Okay, Amber.
Okay. I'm getting ready to...
Okay, you have a walkie. If anything, if you get freaked out completely, you know, just let us know. We'll be down. Okay?
All right. Bye, guys. Right. And good luck. Okay. Wish me luck.
Good luck to you, too.
Thanks.
Is this where you
This device that I have in my hand, it won't hurt you. It's just here to monitor and let me know that you're with me. I feel like there was a man named Samuel who was thrown in this cage, treated like an animal, like filth. Like the scum of the earth. Did you die in this cell? What did it sound like to be you? Hello? Just thought I heard a footstep. Can you mimic this? No way. That was very, very good. Can you do that again, please? I'm gonna do it again. Were those your footsteps I just heard? I think I just heard you. Bass.
Here.
Yeah,
we're coming.
Okay. was intense. Okay.
Whew. Oh, you got some stones.
Yeah, let me get, oh, man.
Oh, great wizard, we summon you forth from beyond.
What wisdom do you desire?
I need a sword!
Magical potions!
Oils and stones!
Fairy wand!
Then you must journey to the Magic Cauldron.
At Magic Cauldron, you can find all the things you need. We have a unique selection of jewelry, candles, books, wands, oracle cards, and so much more.
Okay, Heather, cell number 2, your new home for the next half hour.
Flashlight.
Okay, with Amber having completed her solitary session, time now for Heather to do her solo session in cell number 2. This is a solitary confinement cell. The original locks have been removed, as you can see, but we're actually going to sandbag her in with about 250 pounds of sandbags right up against this door. There's absolutely no way that she would be able to get out. It'd be interesting to see if she can communicate with some of the poor souls who are locked in these terrible cells and forgotten about.
If you can, possibly tell me your name. Tell me your name.
And I want to say that there's a Samuel, a Sam man, a Samuel. I feel like there was a man named Samuel who was thrown in this cage.
Temperature has definitely dropped in here. Side of my face is just so cold.
I'm very conflicted and, yeah, skeptical.
Talking to a psychic over the phone is a bit impersonal.
They can't be for real, can they?
We let these skeptics try California psychics, and here's what they had to say.
You know, it was probably the best psychic reading I've ever had.
Gosh, I got everything I can imagine from my reading.
She's telling me all this stuff, and I'm like, how can you possibly know that?
Call now to speak to a psychic for $1 per minute, and if it's not the best psychic reading you've ever experienced, it's free.
I wasn't sure about the relationship that I'm in, but now I know he's the right one.
It was specific to me. I mean, she picked up on so many things that there's no way she could have picked up on.
I've always had a passion for fitness, and she saw me owning my own yoga studio.
Speak to a psychic for $1 per minute. Readings are secure and confidential. If it's not the best psychic reading you've ever experienced, it's free.
She had names. She had so much detail.
She really just reassured me that I'm on the right path.
I've never had a phone call make me so excited for the future.
California Psychics, the best or it's free. Call today.